Today we are in the glorious sunshine state of California to ride the Moto Guzzi California, as well as meet its creator, Miguel Galluzzi. Now Galluzzi is to the motorcycle world what Giorgetto Giugiaro is to the car world. He spent the last 20 years informing and influencing a whole generation of riders, including myself, with bikes such as the incredible Ducati Monster. But most recently, he set up the Advanced Design Center for Piaggio in Pasadena, and that's exactly where we're going to head.
The Advanced Design Center opened its doors in 2012, allowing Galluzzi and his small team to consider the future of motorcycle design, as well as continue to shape Piaggio's current global folio, including the Moto Guzzi California, where both the full-fed touring and low-riding custom versions are taking the fight firmly to Harley-Davidson's heartland.
Miguel, great to meet you. I've just been spending the day in California, riding in California, and I've been so surprised at how agile this thing is. I guess it's really important because it also marks the dawn of a new era for Moto Guzzi, and it's the first bike that you designed.
The Moto Guzzi California is the first new complete bike in many, many decades for Guzzi. So it's not only, you know, bringing this tradition of the California forward, but it's introducing elements in the cruiser market that everybody was surprised about. Especially, you know, the rideability that you have with the bike. Also, we have the traction control, so you are not anymore in any cruiser. You are in a Guzzi, you know, California.
Is there a design element on the California that you're particularly proud of?
Yeah, I think we did a great job, you know, in making this the center of the attention, the engine. Guzzi is about, you know, the engine. That engine, you know, nobody else has, and it's only a Guzzi engine that, in this case, you know, explodes through the gas tank.
If we can talk a little bit about the Advanced Design Studio in Pasadena, it's a year old now. Why the decision to have it in California?
This is a very special place. It's been, you know, the tradition of California to be in the progressive side of many arguments we live in society. And still today, this mixture of cultures, you know, I read some time ago that there are like almost 150 different ethnies, you know, living together. So that creates an environment in which everything is possible.
There's a clear love for motorcycles here that I've detected just from being out for a day. It's tangible and it feels multi-generational.
Again, in California, and I remember coming back in permanently in 2010 and having the idea of, you know, or at least the thinking in Europe was, you know, young kids don't like bikes anymore. But coming here, I discovered that that's not true. And it's because they are out of any statistics, you know, the manufacturers have, because they've been buying cheap motorcycles, spending a few bucks, you know, to make it run. They are cheap in insurance, cheap in driver's license. Even the parts are cheap.
The obsession with technology that has sort of translated through all parts of life, it almost feels like there's been a reaction, a counterculture to that in motorcycles, and a lot of motorcycle riders wanting to return to a simpler time with no traction control, no great fairings and things. Do you have to react to that as a motorcycle designer?
No, in our case, you know, as a Moto Guzzi brand we have in the Piaggio group represents all that. I mean, it's always been about that, you know, just having a very enjoyable riding experience with enough of what you need. We are in a moment in rethinking the way we've been doing things for the last 20 years. And I think it's a very good example, as you said. Everybody's trying to go back, you know, the cafe racer craze, as they call it right now. It's just a way of going back to basics and enjoying the ride.
We've got to talk about Monster. You know, it's the bike you're most famous for, and it rescued a company. It's that big. But am I right in thinking that you were actually making sketches of the Monster when you were still at uni?
I remember I was in the university in the 80s, and if you remember the 80s, all the motorcycles were full of plastic. So to me, the full of plastic thing, even the cars, were everything aerodynamic, and, you know, and we were in a phase that everything should have been, you know, like a fish. But motorcycles were not like that, never like that. And I remember the first time, you know, thinking about a bike like that was, you know, we would ride Angeles Crest Highway here, you know, the number 2 freeway, which is a very popular, is still very popular to go and ride motorcycles. And we will have all these motorcycles. I have a Suzuki with a 16 inches wheel, which were, you know, the latest technology. But I had at that time, you know, a friend that had a Bonneville 69 from 1969, and the guy would be always on our back, you know, just riding along, you know, with a bigger handlebar and having a different experience than us. So the first moment, you know, I said, but we are getting crazy. And this was like 30 years ago. So right now it feels kind of like that. The Monster was born out of frustration of not finding the basic elements to ride. I think we are in the same phase. The only difference to me right now is that the technology we have today, we can make a lot better. Yeah. And that's, you know, what is really making me push forward to see a different type of bike, but with that simplicity, with that few elements that is more than enough we need, you know, to ride. And I think, as you said, you know, the UK is just a little bit behind, but they're going to come. You know, they're going to come because that's motorcycle. When you start enjoying the ride in a different way, in an affordable way, then everything becomes, you know, completely different.
All right, last two questions for you. The first one is, what is the bike that you've designed that you're most proud of? And the last question is, what is the bike that you wish you designed yourself?
I don't have one bike, you know, because I have different projects in different types of my professional life that were very significant. And I can remember the most exciting was the RSV4, in which, you know, we were able to make, to put together the engineers, the designers, and even the racing department, because we had one goal. We wanted to win, you know, the World Superbike Championship. And that was the first time in my experience that we were able to get all these people with one goal, and nobody, you know, we did something amazing because of that. And that was because of a group of people. Then, for sure, there is the first Ducati I ever did in 1990, the 900 Super Sport, that I cut the fairing of my bike, you know, to show, you know, my bosses, you know, we have a nice engine, we have to show this. And I convinced them to do the half fairing. And there was a lot of naivety at the time, you know, naive thinking of a designer that really think anything could be done. But again, there is no one. There is many with different experiences and always going forward, even the California. You know, it was a very, very difficult project because we were doing a motorcycle that was an iconic thing, but we couldn't keep, you know, in the past. And that was, you know, one element. We needed to bring it into the future, but without, you know, leaving the past behind. The past, more than the past, is the tradition of a Guzzi, you know. So that's why when we are able to add elements, you know, that were unique to Guzzi, that is when you understand you have a great project. So I don't have one, they have many, you know. Yeah. And for sure, one thing, you know, that I always, you know, had in mind, my favorite bikers of all the time is the Vincent Black Shadow of the 30s and 40s. I got a chance to meet John Britton once in my life. He came to, you know, to our studio in Varese once. And we were talking about, and we were starting talking motorcycles, and that was his, you know, his special bike for him too. And the bike he did, he tried to improve in that. So that was a bike, you know, that was really, really, really unique. And, yeah, you know, just to be involved in such a way, maybe just a little way, would have been great. Guzzi for me has not only a bright future, it's an unbelievable future, because it's Italian, it's going to be always producing Mandello Dell'Aria, it's always going to be about the motorcycle, it's always going to be about what we actually need, and not everything else.